Hello friends, welcome to Global Tech Learn. In today's video, we will discuss three PowerBI questions, as all three questions are related to role-based date dimension table in PowerBI. Let's look at the questions first. And the first question is, you have a PowerBI report that imports a date table and a sales table from an Azure SQL database data source. The sales table has the following date foreign keys, due date, order date, and delivery date. You need to support the analysis of sales over time based on all the date foreign keys. And the suggested solution is, for each date foreign key, you add inactive relationships between the sales table and the date table. Does this solution will meet the goal? So in this question, given solution is we have to create inactive relationship between dates and the sales. Now let's look at the next question. And in this question, with the same given model, we have to create a reference from due date twice to order date and delivery date within the date dimension tables. So in this question, in Power Query Editor, we have to rename the date query as a due date, and then we have to create a reference from due date twice to make the queries for order date and delivery date. And in a third question, we have to rename the date table as a due date in a field pane. And then we have to use a DEX expression to create order date and delivery date as a calculated tables. So let's see, from given all three solutions, which one works. Now here in Power BI desktop, here you can see we have date dimension table and then we have sales table. Let's look at the model. And here you can see we have date dimension. Under that we have date key, date, month name, quarter, and other fields. And then we have sales table where we have delivery date ID, due date ID, and order date ID. Now, as per the solution given in a first question, that we have to create an inactive relationship between date and the sales table. So let's try to create that. So here we have created a relationship between date and the sales table based on the date key and the delivery date. And now let's create one more relationship from the date key to the due date. And here you can see the second relationship has the dotted lines. That means it's an inactive relationship. Let's verify this. And here you can see the checkbox to make this relationship active is the unchecked. Now let's create a third relationship, that is from date to the order date ID, and this should also the inactive relationship. So as per the given solution, all three relationship needs to be inactive. So let me inactive the first relationship as well. Now we have all three inactive relationship between date and the sales. Now let's go to the report view and let's plot one analysis for sales over the time. So let's add sales quantity from here. And along with this, we need to add the date. So let me add date over here. And let's change this visual type to the matrix for more understanding of the presentation. So in this analysis, we can see we are getting the same sold quantity for all the dates. There is no change in the data. That means the data is incorrect on this analysis. So the first solution is not a correct answer. So we can mark this as a no. Now let's go to the second solution. And here we have to rename the date query as a due date. And then due date has twice reference to the order date and delivery date. So let's try that. So let's go to the Power Query. And here first we have to rename the date to the due date. So let's rename it. And then we have to create a references. So let's close this. And under model view, we have to create two references from due date to the delivery date and the order date. So let me remove this relationship. And now we have two relationships, that is between due date to the order date and the due date to the delivery date. Now let's go back to the analysis and let's see if we are getting the correct data. And here you can see we are not able to see correct data yet, as all the records have the same figure. So we can mark this solution as the no. Now let's look at the third solution, that is from field pane, you rename the date table as the due date. You use a DAX expression to create order date and delivery dates as a calculated tables. So now let's go back to the model view once again, as we already have due date and we need to create a two tables, order date and delivery date, from this due date using DAX. So let's try to create that. For that we have to go to new table, and under DAX expression we have to provide the delivery date is equals to due date. Now let's create one more table, and this time it should be order date equals to due date. Now we have all three date tables as per the given solution. And now let's create a new relationship. So let me remove this existing relationships. And now let's create a new relationships based on the available table. So first, from due date, we have to create a relationship with the due date within the sales. Similarly, from delivery date, we have to create a reference to the delivery date. And last reference from the order date ID to the date key within the order date table. Now here you can see all three relationships are rigid line. Those are not the dotted line. So these are the active relationships. So now let's go back to the report view. And this time here you can see, along with the date, we are getting the correct figures. This is not a repeated figure. And also, for the filtering purpose, we have three dates over here. So we can add three slicers over here for more interactions. So here we have quarters for delivery date. So we can name it as a delivery date. Let's first make it as a slicer. And under formatting, let's add title, delivery date. Let's create a copy of this slicer. And this time, instead of delivery date, let's add due date. And let's rename it to the due date. And then the third slicer is for order date. So let's add that. Now we have all three slicers on the screen. And let's try to apply some filters using these slicers. So here you can see the filters are working fine. So the filters are working fine with all the three slicers based on the different dates, that is delivery date, due date and order dates. So with this we can conclude that creating a copy of the date table using the DAX and create a relationship with each date to each table as an active relationship is the correct solution. So now let's look at the given third solution again, and this one we can mark it as a correct answer.